we are asked to write sigma notation, also referred to as summation notation, for the finite sum, then determine the sum. Let's first analyze the sum to see if we can determine a pattern. Notice 7 plus 5 equals 12. 12 plus 5 equals 17. 17 plus 5 equals 22. And this continues all the way out to 62. Because we add 5 to determine each successive term, this is an arithmetic sum or an arithmetic series, which means we can use the arithmetic formulas shown here below to help us write the sum using sigma notation. Let's begin by determining the formula a sub n that will generate the terms of the series. The first term in the series is 7, which means a sub 1 equals 7. And because the pattern is that we add 5 to determine each successive term, the common difference d equals 5. There's also a formula to determine the common difference d, given by a sub n minus a sub n minus 1, which means to determine the common difference d, we can use any term in the series and subtract the term before it. Notice 22 minus 17 is equal to 5, and so is 17 minus 12, as well as 12 minus 7. And now we can use this information to determine the formula for a sub n. A sub n is equal to a sub 1, the first term, which is 7, plus the quantity n minus 1, times the common difference d, which is 5. And now we will simplify the formula by distributing 5 and combining like terms. We have a sub n equals 7 plus, distributing 5, we have 5 times n, which is 5n, and then minus 5 times 1, which is 5. Simplifying, notice 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, giving us a sub n equals 2 plus 5n. Which means for sigma notation or summation notation, using the variable n as the index, n begins at the value of 1. The formula that generates the terms in the series is 2 plus 5n. And now we're left to determine the upper limit of the index, or the last value of n, which is the value of n that generates the last term, which is 62. To do this, we can set the formula 2 plus 5n equal to 62 and solve for n. So if we set 2 plus 5n equal to 62 and solve for n, we first subtract 2 on both sides of the equation. Simplifying, we have 5n equals 60. Divide both sides by 5. Simplifying, we have n equals 12. And now we have the sum, or the series, written using sigma notation. And now for the second part of the question, we are asked to determine the partial sum, or the sum of the given series. And we can do this using the formula for S sub n, where n is the number of terms, and therefore this sum is going to be S sub 12. As soon as we write S sub 12, we know n is equal to 12, so S sub 12 is equal to n divided by 2, which in this case is 12 divided by 2, times the quantity A sub 1 plus A sub n is A sub 1 plus A sub 12, or the sum of the first term and the last term in the series, which in our series is 7 plus 62. Simplifying, 12 divided by 2 is 6, and 7 plus 62 is 69. 6 times 69 is equal to 414, which means the sum of the series, or S sub 12, is equal to 414. I hope you found this helpful.